Join us online at charlierose.com. George Clooney, the actor, was on my television program recently. He said to me, he got a call from you, suggesting, because of his interest in Darfur, that if they let you, you could do what in Darfur?
What we, you know, as an idea to at least evaluate. Imagine a force of just some professional advisors, a couple hundred folks that could go and help the African Union or the UN soldiers be even better at their jobs. Help them make sure their vehicles are running, that they have a communications plan, that they have batteries and radios, the basic elements of soldiering, to get them out there, to get them patrolling, to give them some helicopter medevac support, so that if one of them gets hurt, I mean, troops, it's a fact, they do better if they know that they're going to get taken care of if something bad happens.
So it's a support mission. It wasn't, as someone also said about you, because how much you love the Navy SEALs, that you have dreamed of creating this private army that could be a lightning quick response and deal with circumstances like Rwanda, like Darfur, and perhaps other hotspots, essentially saying, let me take care of it. I can do this. I have the men, I have the skill, I have the training, I have the know-how. Let me take over some of the responsibilities of peacekeeping in the world.
Now, that's too far of an assumption. But who can watch the movie Hotel Rwanda and not wish it had a different outcome? Who didn't wish that the UN would have sent troops or yanked those Belgian commandos back there to secure that hotel and to provide some safe havens? I mean, you let almost a million people in a country about the size of Maryland get killed by farm tools over 4 months.
You're basically saying Erik is prepared to go on peacekeeping missions before the UN can go, before other people can go. We want to do that. That's what we're qualified and trained to do.
I can't go and offer those kind of offensive services. I'm saying if...
Have you thought about this might be a place I'd like to go?
Again, you watch the movie Hotel Rwanda or Sometimes in April or one of those and say, man, someone's got to do something. And, if someone asked us to do that, to say, hey, go send 500 or 600 folks to create some safe, secure the airport, take that radio station off the air so that it's not inciting the hoodoos to keep killing the Tutsis. Yes, private sector could have done that, and we would welcome the oversight. Send 50 U.S. military advisors or U.N. military officers from some country. Send them along. Make it a joint operation, but someone do something before that happens again.
Join us online at charlierose.com.